Okay, now, members, we are going to take up, the next bills will be Perry, Edwards, Murphy, Caldwell, and Diaz. So Representative Perry, you're recognized to explain your bill. 1325, the Gainesville Regional Utility Commission.
Thank you, Madam Chair and Committee. This bill is a local bill that deals with our Gainesville region utilities. It is fairly simple. If this bill passes, it would put a referendum vote for the city electors to decide whether or not they wanted an independent board that would be underneath the city commission to manage Gainesville regional utilities, and that is the bill.
Okay, and I believe you do have an amendment on the bill?
And the amendment really is a, it just really deletes unnecessary and repetitive provisions in the original bill.
Okay. Members, are any questions on the amendment? Vice Chair Moritas.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I noticed it says it's going to cost $160,000 to set this board up and pay for it. What are the savings you think will be achieved by the board?
Representative Perry.
Thank you. Well, we hope, we, Gainesville region utilities, we have the highest rates in the state of Florida, and they continue to rise. And so we hope that out of a $375 million enterprise, that this independent board that would focus solely on the management of Gainesville region utilities would have an opportunity to do cost savings across the board. We're one of the largest utilities, or are the largest utilities that's still managed by the city commission. So we hope to have the city commission appoint, and it would be under the direction of the city commission that would be appointed to manage the daily, not the daily, but to be the board of directors for Gainesville region utilities.
Okay, Representative Murphy.
Thank you, Madam Chairman, and thank you, Representative. Was the bill brought to you by the delegation, like a regular local bill, or where did this one start?
Representative Perry.
Thank you. This started when constituents, lots and lots of constituents, one in particular, my wife, when she paid our GRU bill every month.
Yeah, we tend to do that.
But lots and lots of constituents came, brought this to my attention.
Any other questions on the amendment? Okay, do I have anyone in the audience that wishes to speak on the amendment? Doesn't appear to be so. Debate on the amendment? Okay, seeing none, will, you're recognized to close on your amendment? Great, without objections, we'll show that amendment adopted. Now we're back on the bill as amended. Members, are there any questions on the bill as amended? Okay, seeing none, we have Craig Carter wishing to speak.
Madam Chair, as a member, Craig Carter, City Commissioner, Gainesville, Florida, representing 125,000 people. The city commission has heard Representative Perry loud and clear that change needs to come. We started back in January of '14, and talking throughout ourselves about possible governance systems and about a governing board. Recently, we did take a vote in opposition unanimously to this bill. One of the things that concerns the city commission, right now, we are in the search of a general manager. Should this bill come out of this committee today, that would literally cripple our search for general manager, because in this bill, it would not allow that general manager to carry over to the new position, as the bill was stated. And so as we go forward, we hear Representative Perry loud and clear. We are working as fast as we can with seven people, trying to come up with a good governance system for GRU. Just as early as last night, the citizens voted for city commissioners in a runoff to change the makeup of the very commission that caused a lot of these problems. I am a newly represented, elected representative. The board has, the city commission has been in a steady change, and we understand that we represent a lot of people in the city of Gainesville with GRU. We respect representatives' concerns. We are trying to address them. Where he is correct, we do have the highest utility rates, and all the utility rates throughout the state of Florida go up, just as inflation will always cause things to go up. We also have a wide, diverse power system. We have biomass, we have solar feed, and we have coal-fired, and we also have natural gas. These are some of the things that we're very proud of at the city of Gainesville, where we do understand that we need to control our rates. These things did come at a cost at another city commission. This bill will not reverse those contracts. We are in the position we're in. And I'm asking you today for a no vote so we can go out and attempt to hire a general manager to run our utilities in an efficient manner for all the citizens they serve in and outside of the city of Gainesville.
Representative Smith.
Thank you, Madam Chair. When was the GRU established?
Over 100 years ago.
Follow up?
Yes.
Thank you. You said you heard the representatives' issues this year and that long term of the steady increase of power bills in that area. Why did it take until just last year for this to become an issue for you guys to finally address it?
I would say the makeup of the city commission member is steadily changing. I would say that we had a city commission that was, quite frankly, more interested in a power plant than the rates, and I don't think Representative Perry can disagree with that. I think the citizens are voting people in right now to look at the full aspect of GRU, the rates and the power supplies.
Follow up?
Yes, sir.
Has this not been also a change of policy back and forth continuously during that 100 years?
I could not address back to 100 years, to be quite frank with you.
One more?
Other questions? Oh, you want to follow up?
Just one last one.
No, go ahead.
Do you not think that what the representative is about to do will help prevent the consistent increase of rates in that area?
I disagree with that. I don't see how you can stop increase of rates when you always have inflation. Rates are going to go up no matter what utility. That has been a proven fact. You cannot stop rates.
Anywhere, are there questions?
I
have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm sorry. Ranking Member Campbell, go ahead.
Thank you, Madam Chair. You know, this is troubling me a lot because for me to see you standing here and asking us to vote no on something so good, he tried to help you guys out. Because as a constituent and elected official, for me to be representing my constituent and then they have a rate increasing, you know, every month or whatever the increase is, and 100 years this thing been there, and he tried to help you and you're standing here telling us to vote no on it. You should congratulate him and say thank you, Representative Perry, for changing this, because the constituent need a break. So I will vote yes for it, and congratulations for this.
I respect you.
Thank you.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
How many of your ratepayers live in the unincorporated area?
I don't have that number off the top of my head. Approximately a third.
Okay. And do you have a utility director?
A general manager or director of utilities?
A director of utilities.
I don't know what you're asking. I mean, we have the general manager of utilities. And
okay.
Yes.
So the general manager.
We have an interim general manager right now, madam.
Okay, so the general manager that you're talking about is the utility director, and he's the new person coming on board.
Nobody's coming on board right now. We have an interim general manager at this time. We've made drastic changes at GRU by replacing the governance of GRU, the running of GRU.
Uh-huh.
We are in the search right now. We start interviews next week, and we had to disclose this bill to those candidates, which obviously, if they don't know what their future is going to be. And to address, we do respect our ratepayers, and we just feel that this is something that the citizens themselves are actually handling at home through the process of voting.
Right. And now, but this is also a referendum as well.
Yes, ma'am.
So those people, the citizens, will get to vote again whether or not they want to go in this direction.
Yes, ma'am, it is. But it is our belief, as long as this bill is in process right now, it'll stifle our ability to bring a general manager in, and it'll actually have an adverse effect on getting the company, the GRU, going forward. That is our beliefs, ma'am.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Okay, members, there's no one else in the audience wishing to speak. Brian Pitts, Justice for Jesus. Now, I'm assuming you have all these appearance cards all filled out, stacked, and
I'm going to get them to you.
Okay. Good job.
Right. And I was looking at, I was going to ignore this, actually. But if you said, okay, even if it's by random referendum, guess what it is? It's still an expansion of government. So there's going to be an increase, an entity or board or whatever, which did not exist before,
you're telling them to go and vote on. And most likely, they probably say, yeah. What they don't know about the year is you now have, it wasn't one entity, and you're unhappy with it. Now you got that entity you was unhappy with, and a new one to take care of your utilities that never showed up on your ad valorem statement before. Also, this new entity, whatever powers and authorities it will have with the entity you don't like right now. Now, the people are not going to know that when they vote. They're not going to see the expansion of the government of another entity that may end up taxing them to death eventually. So when you say save money, and you say, well, they're going to vote. Come on, they're going to vote for it. Come on, they're going to think, oh, yeah, that's a great idea. But what is this entity eventually going to do if it gets out of hand? Versus, here we go again, dealing with diplomacy. And I understand, unfortunately, it got heated up here a little bit, but very politely. But that's why I tell you, okay, the sponsor didn't mention anything about him doing proper diplomacy, like you always say. And it's not an issue of a stakeholder issue. This is even more important, diplomacy. Who knows how long it may take? It may be very stringent. Yeah, it may be lies, all that kind of garbage. But you weed through that. As elected officials, you're supposed to say, hey, we're going to be honest with one another. Do I need to do this bill today? Sponsor didn't do that. So you have hostility coming up from the other side, whether legitimate or not. The thing is, that ought not happen in a committee like this. The sponsor should have said straight up, I've already dealt with it. We couldn't come to any agreement. Yes, they're probably here today, but they're going to be able to say, I tried to work with them. Everything else, it didn't work out. No, that's not what the sponsor said. And that's what I would expect from elected officials to be said. So it wouldn't be this hostility, which you just saw. Well, y'all always say, I'm saying again, get with stakeholders, or what's the county's position or the government. You always say, you didn't do it on this one. So you want to attack the gentleman, whether he's saying true or not. The issue is we see diplomacy was not done. In other words, he did not say, there's nothing else we could do. We got to move with this bill. I've tried and worked with him. It didn't work out. That's not what the sponsor said. That's besides the point that the sponsor not thinking that it can be expansion of government. And now, in this bill, it doesn't take consider the savings or loss on that. You're supposed to be representing the people and everything they won't be thinking about when they vote on something or get involved in something. You're not doing that on this. It's got some more stops. Yeah, I'm going to see this later. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pitts. Okay, members, we're in debate. Representative Moraitis.
I normally would defer to the cities on something like this. I just, after reading some of the staff analysis, particularly the recommendation from the chambers that, you know, this utility, and Representative Perry's testimony, this utility has one of the highest rates in the entire state, that other cities have gone to these other governance models that Representative Perry is suggesting they've achieved significant savings. And so even though we're creating another level of government, which I know we don't like to do, in this case it seems to be a good idea, so I'll be voting the bill. Yes.
Any other debate? Any other debate? Okay, I just want to make a few comments on it, too. I understand exactly where Representative Perry is coming from on this, because I have the same issue in Vero Beach. You have 33% of the constituents that are ratepayers that have no representation on the city because they do not live in the city limits in the unincorporated area. And in speaking with Representative Perry, it's my understanding that he has worked with the city council. They have asked for changes, and the citizens are not being recognized in what the issues are, and the city continues to continue to do what they want to do because they can. So, Representative Perry, I commend you for bringing this bill forward. I don't view this as another layer of government. I view it as taking a utility away from the city with an independent board that's going to oversee it, that's going to have the best interest of the ratepayers in mind, not necessarily the revenue that the city's going to be able to generate from a utility fund that they have. So with that, I will be supporting the bill. And Ranking Member Campbell.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Representative Perry, I really commend you for this, because you're really standing up for the constituent you represent, because you don't let, you know, the city or county, you know, take over your constituents, and I commend you for that. Thank you very much for standing up for your constituents.
Great. And with that, Representative Perry, you're recognized to close.
Thank you. And first, thank you, Chair, for working with us in this, and Eric Miller, for you and your staff working, helping us get this thing in right posture and then agended. Just one thing, and I'll certainly address this later. I'm pretty sure that we addressed the management issue already in this bill. I spoke with the mayor, and I spoke with Commissioner Carter and some other ones. So that provision, I believe, is taken out of this. I will check that. If it's not, it will be at the next stop. But this is simply what the to give the voters a chance to decide themselves on the governing structure. So I would ask for your favorable support. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. Martha, will you please call the roll?
Chair Mayfield?
Yes.
Representatives Caldwell?
Yes.
Campbell?
Yes.
Diaz?
Yes.
Dudley?
Yes.
Moraitis?
Yes.
Murphy?
Yes.
Pigman?
Yes.
Rader?
Yes.
Ray?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
Stone? Sullivan?
Yes.
The bill passes.
Great. Members, by your vote, we'll show House Bill 1325 reported favorably. Okay.